We're going to say that metals tend to lose electrons to become positively charged ions called cations. Okay, we're going to say metals that have only one charge associated with them are referred to as type 1 metals. Okay. So let's take a look. Remember we talked about this way back, the subdivisions of the periodic table. Remember we said that there's a staircase right here? Okay. And we said that these guys here are the metalloids. Okay, so those are your metalloids. And then everyone to the right of them are going to be your nonmetals, including hydrogen. And then everything else on the periodic table is a metal. Now, we're going to say we have main group metals. We're going to say that the charge of group 1A is plus 1. Group 2A is plus 2. Group 3A is plus 3. Now, we're going to ask ourselves, why do these guys have these charges? Let's think about this for a second. Here we look at lithium. Lithium is Li. Okay. Lithium has 3 electrons. Okay, why do we know it has 3 electrons? Because just say that all the elements on the periodic table are in their neutral forms. Here, this is the atomic number. So according to the atomic number, we have 3 protons. Since we're assuming everyone is neutral on the periodic table, the number of protons and the number of electrons must be the same. So if my atomic number is 3 and I'm neutral, that must mean I have 3 protons, but more importantly, I have 3 electrons. So lithium has 3 electrons. Lithium wants to become just like a noble gas. It wants to become just like a group 8A element. Now, lithium has 2 choices to go. It can either try to gain 7 electrons to become like neon, which is very unlikely, or it could just lose 1 electron and become like helium, which has 2 also. Remember, you always go the shortest distance to get to a noble gas. So it's better for lithium and the other group 1A metals to lose 1 electron. So neutral lithium has 3 protons, which are all positive, and 3 electrons. When it loses one of its electrons, it's not going to have 2 electrons and become perfect, just like helium. But its number of protons have to stay the same, because if you change the number of protons, you change the identity of the element. So your number of protons are staying the same. The only thing that's changing are the number of electrons. And that's how we know lithium gains a plus 1 charge, because we have more positives than we do negatives. In the same way, beryllium wants to lose 2 electrons to become just like helium. And boron over here will tend to, boron tends to lose electrons as well. We're going to say it loses plus 3, so these guys here lose plus 3 to become just like the noble gas. So we're going to say aluminum, for example, has atomic number of 13. It wants to lose 3 electrons to become 10, just like neon. So again, we're going to say metals tend to lose electrons to become cations. And we're going to say that groups 1A, 2A, and 3A have charges of plus 1, plus 2, and plus 3. Now, they're all type 1 metals because they only have 1 charge. Now, we're going to say metals that have more than 1 charge are referred to as type 2 metals. These are traditionally our transition metals. Transition metals tend to have more than 1 charge. And remember, we said the transition metals are the guys here in the pit. So these guys tend to have more than 1 charge. For example, iron has 2 charges, plus 2 or plus 3. Chromium does too. A lot of them have more than 1 charge. There are 3 of them, though, that even though they're transition metals, they have only 1 charge. The 3 that follow that trend are silver, which is Ag, silver is always plus 1, cadmium, which is Cd, right next to it is plus 2, and zinc, right above it, is plus 2. These 3 guys are transition metals. We expect them to have more than 1 charge, but they are an exception to that. These are transition metals, but they're type 1 transition metals. They have only one type of charge. Most of the other transition metals have more than one charge, so we would refer to the other transition metals as type 2. Now, we're going to say also that tin here and lead, these two right here, they're both in group 4A. Technically, they're not transition metals, but they act like it. They have more than one charge associated with them. We're going to say tin can be either plus 2 or plus 4, and lead can be either plus 2 or plus 4. So again, SN and PB in group 4A, they're not transition metals, but they act like it. They have more than one charge.